So, Robert, what does Canelo need to do in a rematch? What does Triple G need to do in a rematch? What does each of them have to do? If you're in their corner, you're whispering in their ear.
Fucking sign that contract, because that's going to like make them another fucking $20 million or whatever they made.
Their base pay for this fight, base, $3 million for Triple G, $5 million for Canelo. But that doesn't mean they could get bonuses.
I don't mean that's what they got. They got a lot more.
20 and 40?
They made a lot more.
Oscar said Canelo can make up to $50 million in this fight.
So I'm thinking that's what he made. That's what I'm thinking. And Triple G, probably a little over 10, 15, somewhere around there.
He showed he still has it. He's not old.
That's my guess.
So what is each, boxing-wise, because what did they do in this fight that you would tweak?
No, they did good already. It was a hell of a fight. They just, you know, with Canelo, maybe just he gassed out a little. But he had a monster in front of him. I think in the rematch, he's going to be more confident. And I think he's going to...
He took his best shots.
Yeah, I think he'll dominate better in the rematch. Canelo will. You know, that's why after first fight on the rematch, you know, the younger one, you know, should do better. I think Canelo should do better. Triple G... going out there looking for that one punch, you know, maybe lands a good hook, maybe set the ring off a little bit more, you know, that's just my opinion. He's got his trainer, he's got a great trainer. One thing that I did, I don't know if many people noticed it, but I think it was after the first round. Pita knows if it was the first or second, but they put the camera on Canelo's corner. And they're telling Canelo after the first round, which I think was a little bit too soon to ask him for that punch, but they were asking for take a little step back and counter with that right uppercut, okay? Which is a good punch. It's a good punch. Canelo has a beautiful uppercut, but it could have been a little bit too soon, but they were asking for that uppercut. And then they go to they put the camera on Triple G's corner. And fucking it seemed like Abel Sanchez was hearing the instructions from Canelo's corner. Because Abel Sanchez is telling him, ¡Órale, guarito! Abel Sanchez is telling Triple G. When he stays back, he tells him, be careful, okay? He's going to try to throw that right uppercut.
Wow.
You know, that's a good trainer there, knowing, you know, because he sometimes... I don't know if you've noticed, but when I'm at some fights, like this last Chocolatitos card, I'm watching the fights, and when during the minute break, I like to see how the corner works. I like to see things that happen in the corner. That's just something that I do. I'll even record the corners, and sometimes even to bring something up to the commission, if they're, you know, there's rules, you know, don't, no water, you know, stuff like that. California doesn't allow no water.
Why not?
They don't allow water in the head. They don't allow Vaseline in the,
see it all the time.
They allow Vaseline going in the face.
The way they wrap hands here is different too.
You know, everything's different. So I like to see how corners work. Maybe, you know, there's a fight in Vegas that happened two years ago maybe. A pay-per-view fight in Vegas. They allow championship fights. They allow four men in the corner, but only three in the ring. The fourth one has to stay in the floor. But in this one fight, every round for 12 rounds, the fourth guy, all four guys were
working the corner in the ring.
Working the corner. And I brought it up. You know, I didn't write nobody up, but I said, look, you guys gotta be careful because they're telling me, nope, only three.
Be
only
consistent.
Three. So I say, okay, why did you allow him, that corner, to have four people? So same thing, you know, that's why, you know, I noticed in one of the fights on Chocolatito's card, during the break, they were putting Vaseline in the whole body of one of the fighters.
I saw that.
I want to save it. I want to save it for one day. California's gonna tell us, no Vaseline allowed. I say, why did you allow him? And there's an inspector right there watching the what's going on in the corner. How come the inspector never told him, don't do it? You know, or even when Mares fought Cuellar, during the break, they were putting water on Cuellar's head. They were putting water on Cuellar's head, and they're not supposed to.
Is that because they're afraid the mat will get people will slip?
Yeah, they do that. No, and they, you know, sometimes we get away with it too. I'm not saying I've never done it. We get away with it too, but you know, sometimes they do it in your eyes, and they still allow it.
So, if in a rematch, you're saying Canelo might stop Triple G. Early stoppage, no. Or late stoppage, or middle round?
No, it can't be early. It has to be late, because Triple G is still very strong, still has great power, great skills. But I just think, especially the fights in September of next year, 1 year from now, Triple G is going to be older. So, I think he might be able to stop him.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Ellie Sekpak.